When Gandhi catches cold, India sneezes. In the womb of the history, we find several characters. They become great neither by power nor by money. They remain reverential for their sacrifice. They sacrificed everything not for their personal gain or fame. They are the replica of divine power. The Lord Buddha, Mahavir, Sri Swami Vivekananda, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, the list goes on. India has a galaxy of such characters. The whole country stood behind Mahatma Gandhi. In general, the people accept a personality which is pure, sincere, and trustworthy. Such persons grow to a great height. They develop a spiritual strength. Gandhi stunned the whole of England when he entered England with a minimum dress to cover his body, in spite of bitter chill of the English climate. Gandhi had sworn that he remains half naked until everyone gets full clothing to cover their body. This message of sacrifice attracted the minds of the common men. That is the reason why it was said, when Gandhi catches cold, India sneezes. Gandhi's simplicity, his idea of India, his spiritual strength could never be compared with any other contemporary personalities. There is a proverb, pen is mightier than sword. Gandhi stood for pen. Pen stands for what is good, what is spiritual, what is positive. The sword stands for what is evil, what is negative, what is cruel. What the sword cannot achieve, the pen achieves. Gandhi realized that pen alone can defeat the mighty brawn of British. He sacrificed his personal pleasures to achieve the goal. He has become reverential in all the corners of the world, not because he enjoyed the power of the chair, but he had won the hearts of millions of people. He had realized that Indian soil does not accept any extreme philosophy. Indian mind had been, has been, and will have been generous enough to embrace the religion of peace. Gandhi proclaimed to the world that India is a land of spiritual supremacy, not craving for material supremacy. The goal of such characters is not an award or a position. Their ultimate aim is to teach the values in life. When a man achieves that supreme knowledge, he becomes a divine force. Once, a great Sanskrit Pandit goes to a king and boasts that he has studied the Bhagavatam and asked the king to give him an award. The king was also a great scholar and told him to study the Bhagavatam again and meet him. The Pandit went back and studied the text and returned to the king and asked for the reward. The king repeated the same and asked him to come a few months later. The Pandit became angry and went back scolding the king. This time, he studied the Bhagavatam with utmost sincerity and dedication and devotion. Then he realized the futility of the worldly pleasure and fame. He then never thought of going to the king for the award. The king then asked his minister about the Pandit. The minister, after a thorough search, came to know that he is leading a life of a hermit in a hermitage. The king then decides to go to the hermitage with all his men. The king, with all state honor, prostrates to the Pandit. The Pandit has now realized that the knowledgeable man is the king. King invited the Pandit to his palace and said that he is now a saint, not a Pandit. Those who work for the general good of the society are the real saints. Mahatma Gandhi is one such personality. The Pandit who renounced the earthly pleasures and the rewards for his knowledge became enlightened because he went deep into the spiritual knowledge expressed in the Bhagavatam. The prudent king knew that he had not gone deep into the texts. We are really blessed to be guided by great texts and great personalities. Perhaps These qualities of our land has taken our country to a great height. This article is written by Professor S.C. Gauri Shankar and voice artist Sejal. Dear listeners, if you wish to listen to more such audiobooks, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Kannada Times Audiobooks. For further details, visit our Facebook page, facebook.com/Kannada Times Audiobooks, and like our page. Thank you.